I didn't realise my twin was going to be here tonight. Getting a lot of fucking stage time. I won't fucking stand for it, Mike. All right, sorry. Domestic outdoor, sorry. So, a little bit about me. My name is Dara. I'm Irish. I'm 32. Just gone 33. That's changed. I'm the youngest of seven kids. I work in construction, and I absolutely fucking love alcohol. So, for example, I was at the pub the other day. Had about three or four too many pints, as the Irish tend to do. And my mate said to me, Dora. Yeah, that's how English people pronounce my name. Like I'm going to jump up and start exploring the place. He said, Dora, you've had too many, mate. Leave your car at the pub and take the fucking train home. So I did. I'd never actually driven a train before, though. Good fucking crack, to be honest. Great crack. I don't know why you're always striking. Why you're always striking. 69 grand, man. I do it all day. Chew fucking chew, baby. Yeah, so obviously now I have a terrorism charge against my name, being Irish and robbing the train. So CPS says I have a drinking problem. So I sat down with myself recently and I had a good look at myself in the mirror. I said, Dara, you need to sort it out, mate. You need to fucking give up the drink. And then I thought, am I really going to listen to some drunk fella who talks to himself? Arthur Guinness would fucking roll in his grave. There's a reason, like, if Irish invented things, right? And then the 14th century, we invented whiskey. And fuck all happened for 300 years. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. So, yeah, to try and give it up, I've taken up a lot of hobbies, right? But one of the hobbies I've actually taken up is gardening. And gardening can be quite expensive, you know? So I've come up with a few money-saving tricks. All the snails I have in my garden, I swap for wine to the French guy next door. And instead of petrol, I put vodka in my lawnmower. The lawn's half cut. So yeah, like I said, I'm the youngest of seven kids. Just move on swiftly. I'm the youngest of seven kids, and being the youngest of seven kids makes you pretty sure that you're an accident. But that wasn't the only thing in my family. My sisters would tell me, you're fucking annoying me. Go play with traffic. My brothers would tell me the best part of you ran down our mother's leg. But it's actually true, though. But the one that really put the cherry on top was my father pulled me aside one day and he goes, did you know that you were conceived on the motorway? I said, really? On the motorway? He goes, yeah. He goes, that's where most accidents happen. Now, being Irish, being the youngest of seven, people just assume you're religious and Catholic, whatever. But my family, we didn't go to church. We went to things like weddings, funerals, christenings, anything that lasted 3 days and had an open bar. Front and centre, man. You'd be at a funeral, you'd have a coffin on that shoulder, you'd have a beer in this hand, you don't have a fucking clue who's in the box. But you know nobody's going to ask you to leave because you've just done your part, like. Let's be honest. That's a lot harder to do at a christening, though, just so you're aware. Yeah. So yeah, to combat that, I've had enough of being the dark sheep of the family. I decided I'm going to get a family of my own. So I got myself a partner and a stepson. Was it the wisest choice? Much like an open casket funeral, remains to be seen. But no, it has. I've grown a lot in this relationship. My partner has taught me a lot, opened my eyes to certain things. Like, for example, I now realise exactly why most archaeologists are women. For their innate ability to dig up the past. And yeah, being a stepdad, that's an eye-opener. I love it. Don't get me wrong, I love it. But discipline is very, very tricky. Like the other day, I walked in from work and my stepson was in the front room just chewing on an electrical cable. Just chewing away, like. So I was like, this is my moment, right? This is my moment. I'd done what any good dad would do. I grounded him until he could conduct himself properly. Thank you. Good night.